Welcome back to Luna Basics. In this video, we'll go over the essentials of editing audio in Luna. Luna has a number of powerful and intuitive features for editing recorded or imported audio. For this demo, I'm going to import some previously recorded audio for editing. However, you can check out the previous video in this series to learn how to record your own audio into Luna. Audio can be imported into Luna by using the Import option in the File menu, or by simply dragging and dropping audio files into the timeline or tracks list. Luna will automatically create a new track for each audio file that you import, and each file will show up as a clip in the timeline. MIDI can also be imported into Luna in the same way. Each audio clip has its own name as well as non-destructive gain and pitch controls that can be adjusted from the clip header. To the right of the clip name is a small fader icon that represents clip gain, which is used to change the volume of a clip without changing the overall track volume. Clip gain can be adjusted by clicking on the icon and dragging up or down, or by double-clicking and typing in a value. The pitch control to the right can be adjusted in the same way, and is used to pitch the clip up or down by up to 24 semitones. Clicking on the clip name opens a popover where you can adjust both of these settings via knobs, as well as rename the clip, mute the clip, or adjust warp settings, which we'll cover in a separate video. Clips are arranged and edited in the timeline using a contextual editing tool that allows you to perform a number of actions simply by moving your mouse cursor over different areas of the clip. For example, clips in the timeline can be moved around by dragging from either the clip header or bottom half of the clip. By default, clip movement is snapped to the grid, meaning that clips can only be moved in incremental steps based on the current grid value. This behavior can be toggled by clicking the snap button in the bars and beats ruler, or by using the shortcut shift backslash. The current grid value is set using the grid menu next to the snap button. To select a grid value, either click on the grid menu and select a value, or hold down the shift key and use the plus or minus keys to cycle through the values. For example, if I set the grid value to bar and enable snap, clips can be moved through the timeline in one bar increments. If I set the grid value to half bar, clips can be moved in half bar steps and so on. You can also hold down the command key while moving clips to temporarily ignore the grid without having to turn snap off. Similar to how you can drag the clip header or bottom half of a clip to move it in the timeline, you can also drag at the bottom of either end of a clip to change its length, or at the top of either end to add a fade. Once a fade is added, you can further edit its shape using the breakpoint in the middle of the fade. To select a section of a clip in the timeline, drag in the top half of the clip. Edits like trimming or adding fades can be applied to multiple clips at once by first selecting the clips and then editing one of them. For example, if I select two clips in the timeline by dragging or holding down the shift key and clicking each one, I can trim or add a fade to both clips at the same time. If two clips are adjacent, you can add a crossfade that affects both clips by dragging at the middle of the edge where the clips meet. Crossfades add a smooth transition between the two clips by evenly fading in the second clip as the first clip fades out. Just like regular fades, once a crossfade is placed, you can change its curve by dragging the breakpoint in the middle. Fades can also be added using actions in the edit workflow, where you'll find a number of other editing functions including cut, copy, paste, duplicate, separate, and consolidate. Any of these functions can be used by clicking the corresponding action button in the edit workflow, or by using the keyboard shortcut assigned to that function. For example, cut, copy, and paste use the standard shortcuts of Command X, Command C, and Command V, while the duplicate function can be used with the shortcut Command D. Pressing the B key triggers the separate function and splits the clip at the current cursor position. If multiple adjacent clips are selected in the timeline, you can combine them into a single clip by using the consolidate function, which is triggered with the shortcut Option-Shift-3. Shuffle-style shift edits can also be performed using the shift buttons in the edit workflow, or by replacing the command key with the shift key in many of the standard editing shortcuts. For example, instead of using the standard cut function, which leaves an empty space where the clip was, I can use the shift cut button or the shortcut Shift-X to perform a shift cut, which cuts the current selection and shifts all clips after the selection up to fill the space. If I use the normal paste function to paste the clip I just cut, the clip will be pasted over the clip that was in that space before. However, if I use the Shift Paste button or the shortcut Shift V, all clips after the current selection will be shifted down to make room for the pasted clip. The Shift Duplicate button or Shift D works in a similar way by duplicating the current selection and shifting all clips after the selection to the right to make room. Finally, the Shift Insert button or Shift I can be used to insert empty space at the current timeline selection while moving the clips after the selection to the right by the same amount. Note that by default, Luna's edit and playback selections are linked, meaning that if you select an area or clip in the timeline to edit it, playback will start and end at the boundaries of the selection. This behavior can be disabled using the Link Edit Play Selections button found next to the grid menu in the Bars and Beats ruler. When disabled, the playback selection can be set independently using the Bars and Beats ruler, and edit selections can be made in the timeline without affecting the playback position. That covers the fundamentals of editing audio in Luna. Check out the next Luna Basics video to learn all about using instrument tracks.